Welcome to lecture 42.
Today I am going to speak one of the part in continuous casting process, that is about mold making. What are the mold material used in the continuous casting process? How it is made up of? Mainly it is being made up of copper alloys. What are the alloying elements with the copper? AR, chromium and zirconium. And why we use chromium along with the copper is, it is especially used for plating around the thickness of 0.08 inner part of the mold is being given chromium plating. It is mainly made to protect the erosion which arises due to the molten metal flow during the casting process from the mold. And the other part is, the inner cross section is provided with tapering. You see this particular top surface and inner surface, that bottom one area and the top one area is completely different. It is been tapered. The typical tapering is been given in 1 meter length, around 1% in the total volume space which occupies in a 1 meter length mold, 1% is being provided with the tapering. And why do you need to provide this tapering section is, while the continuous casting molten metal is flowing through this mold, it immediately around the surface it starts solidifying. It should not stick to that, and it should be easily moved from the mold to next section of continuous casting strands, which are in the shape of billet bloom and slab shape given by those strands. For that we need to provide the tapering. The next part is, this particular mold is being provided with oscillation. Now the thing is that, why do you need to provide the oscillation? The oscillation is given, assume that the molten metal is flowing in this direction, that is the longitudinal direction. In the transverse direction, the oscillation is provided. And in the case of ingot casting, up and down it has been provided. This is developed by Jungans, that is why it is called Jungans principle. The frequency amplitude maintained for the oscillation are, frequency is 0 to 250 cycles per minute. The stroke length amplitude is 0 to 12 mm is maintained in the case of continuous casting process. Now one need to know what is the main significance of this particular solidification process. Significance of the solidification process is that this is continuous casting mold in a vertical casting method. As a molten metal is poured from the ladle to this particular ladle to tundish to continuous casting mold. Continuous casting is mold is provided with the cooling, which is primary cooling stage, and it is been moved to the box type strands. In one mold there will be a connected strand which is provided with again water spray, which is secondary cooling. And completely, as you see in the mold, this is solidified area and this is solid plus liquid region. As it is been moving from the mold to strand, it is continuously getting solidified. At this stage, as it is been reaching to the rollers, it need to be moved to the next strand, out of the strand to cutting section with the help of rolling. When it is going out of the roll, this particular solidified mushy zone is nothing but liquid plus solid region, should not be extended behind the roller support. It should not be. This should be ended here only. It should not follow this dotted line. If it follows, it leads to the central line crack, which goes to the in casting product, in the finished product. That is why it need to be very crucial, and the solvation need to be completed withdrawal before withdrawal of the rollers. And if it is not followed, there will be a problem of macro segregation and central end cracking, and porosity formation will occur. And this particular solidified shell, this is white region is solidified shell, should be strong enough while it is exiting out from the rollers. It is going to the cutting section and it is going to apply the large pressure. That is why it should be strong enough. Now coming to the, there are emerging trends developed to overcome those kind of defects. This is the your continuous casting direction, Z direction. This is the width of the section. This is transverse direction. This is longitudinal direction. In the longitudinal direction, there will be extra setup which is being arranged with the electromagnetic forces, magnets and electric field. AC or DC is being supplied to the electromagnets. These are the magnets, and through this particular tunnels, the electromagnetic force is being, this is front side, this is the left side, is being provided. Mainly this electromagnetic forces, when the alternative current is supplied, it provides the steering for the this liquid part. This is a solid part. For the liquid part, when it is being subjected to the steering process, you will be achieved the homogeneity in the chemical composition. And when the DC current is being provided, in the case of slab production, thin slab production, the steering is mainly subjected in the billet bloom production. The for the slab production, the DC current is supplied so that the flow will be damped, so that the thickness will be reduced at the stage of, as it is been converted from the liquid to solid. Those are the two advantages of this particular electromagnetic forces application. Essentially, there are two types of continuous casting products are in practice in the industry, in the integrated steel plant and mini steel plants. One is vertical process. This is a ladle, and ladle to flowed the reservoir such as Standish and mold, which has been provided with the primary cooling. And this particular box type and rollers, top and bottom rollers, strand, and finally cutting, and it has been made into the with the regular sections in the vertical. And in the vertical also, it has been straightened, as it has been vertical stands has been coming till here from the mold, and it has been straightened and bending and unbending. This is attached with vertical continuous casting machine. Another thing is curved stand. This up to here is the continuous casting mold. It has been curved through the rollers, upper roller and bottom roller, and it has been bending and unbending, and here it has been straightened. There will be a large number of forces and strains occur, and entrainment of inclusion will occur the top surface in the case of curved stand, whereas in the case of the vertical stand, the strain and application of the residual stresses will be less. Quality is very good, but in the case of this thing, the stresses are large, and the comparatively this is depends upon if you need less stresses to be induced the as per the application requirement, go for the vertical casting section. The stresses and strainness should not be subjected to more to lead to the continuous casting product. Choose the curved process and progressively straightening. And what are the continuous casting defects? Mainly it is divided to internal cracks, which you cannot see. As the product is moving through the strands also, you cannot see. Those kind of things are mid cracks, triple point. These are the weaker points, central line cracks, diagonal cracks, inclusions and blowholes. These surface cracks, longitudinal direction, as a casting molten metal is being flowing through. This longitudinal direction cracks you can clearly see, and opposite to that transverse direction, oscillation marks, the impressions of the molds you will see these are the surface defects. This can be avoided by machining of the some thickness of the surface and shape of this particular due to the uneven forces, oval shape, rhombohedral shape and long depression shape of these things will come along with the casting products. With the, for example, you see the midway cracks, this is middle of the surface. If it is off of the offline of the surface, this is offline crack, and this is corner cracks as initiated at the corner cracks. These are the transverse direction cracks, offline to the transverse direction, midsection, and the diagonal section of the crack. There will be strips, group of the cracks will be developed this in the continuous casting process. All these things can be avoided by applying the mechanical forces, balancing the soft mechanical forces, all those things. It is continuously developed. What are the advantages of continuous casting over the ingot casting? You can do molten metal feeding continuously and finally you will be getting the semi-finished product. Quality is better and you no need to have the slabbing mill, blooming mill and separately, whereas in the case of ingot casting section you need large space, cost operation, investment, capital cost was higher. As it is being developed, it is dominated in the all the integrated steel plant. Nowadays most of the plants are around 95% of the plants are equipped with continuous casting process. Higher extent of automation, stripping, cutting and interval of periodic cutting, the regular section, smoothening, everything can be automated in the continuous casting process. The width also can be adjusted, how much width you want. It is more closer to the finishing products. No more it is called semi-finished products, as development took place in the continuous casting process. The less segregation will be there. Now, I would like to conclude with the points that mention whether these following points are true or false. Midway cracks, triple points and centerline points are the weaker points and which developed due to the non-uniform solidification. These things leads, these are the defects. Henri Bessemer first propagated the concept of continuous casting of steel. So please give your opinion. Thank you.